Happy December, everyone, and thanks so much for watching today's drawing time lapse and studio sessions, episode 46. And first, a quick little reminder that my holiday sale is still going on. If you want to take 20% off your orders of prints, you can use the code Black Friday at my shop at happyd-artist.com, and the sale will end December 25th. Today's video is brought to you by Squarespace, which is what I've been using for the past 4 years to build and host my website and online shop. I absolutely love them, and I'm so honored to bring you guys this special offer. So whether you need a domain, website, or online store, make your next move with Squarespace. Start your free trial today at squarespace.com and visit squarespace.com/happydartist to get 10% off your first purchase. And as usual, I'll be listing all of the art supplies used in today's video along with links to purchase them in the description below. Alright, so we have not done a drawing video in a while. You guys might notice that my background is different, and that is because I recently got a new table. I'm actually using a wooden countertop from IKEA as my tabletop. And I am also editing a bunch of vlogs coming up soon to update you guys on some of the changes I made in my studio, my new plant obsession, and just many other artist life adventures. So hopefully I will have a lot more videos in December than I did last month. I've really been trying to upload every week, but the holiday orders have just kept me super busy, so I apologize that I haven't had a video out in the last 2 weeks. This little drawing measures only 5 by 7 inches, but it still took me a pretty long time to complete. It took me about 2 hours more than I had originally predicted. I think I probably just got lost rendering the little details and my mind was wandering. And because I was a little bit over the amount of time I had booked for myself to finish this drawing, it also pushed a bunch of my other projects back. And now I'm a little bit behind, you know, along with holiday orders. Holidays are always a really busy time for any small business owner or creator. But I also have a lot of painting commissions to complete. I had a last minute gallery show that I decided to join. And, you know, it just kind of put me into a really bad place mentally. I think I've made a lot of videos about dealing with stress and managing your time, and for the most part I feel like I am fairly decent at time management. I'm not perfect, but you know, I always write out a to-do list of what I want to accomplish that day, and I generally am pretty good at estimating how much time I need to finish certain projects, so I can more accurately budget the amount of things that I want to complete in a day. But I, for some reason, feel like lately everything is taking longer than I had predicted. It almost feels like I'm slowing down, or maybe I'm not working as fast as I used to be able to work. You know, I used to be able to do like 3 or 4 of these types of drawings a day. And now I feel like it takes me a whole day or sometimes 2 sessions for me to finish even one small drawing. So yeah, these past 2 weeks I felt a little bit discouraged and down. I just don't feel like I'm on my A game, or maybe, you know, I'm just getting burnt out. I don't know, but it just kind of frustrated me that I'm not working as fast and as efficiently as I used to. And then it got me thinking, maybe I'm just remembering things wrong. Maybe I have this false illusion that I was more productive or more efficient in the past, and that for some reason now I've slowed down, I've lost my touch, I've lost my momentum. But in actuality, when I sit down and really think about things logically, I don't think I've slowed down. I think what actually happened, and I realized this when I was looking over these little drawings. By the way, these are my monthly Patreon drawings that I do as a reward for my patrons. So I do a handful of these every single month, and I've done this for the last 2 years. And when I looked over my drawings in the past versus my drawings now, it actually seems like my older drawings took me less time because my style was a lot more simple and straightforward back then. I didn't have a lot of these complicated shapes like you're seeing in the background here with like several layers of leaves and grass and flowers. There wasn't a lot of overlap between like negative space created by the subject's hair and, you know, all this foliage in the background. And, you know, I realized that it's not me getting slower. It's actually my standard getting higher, or my, I guess my limit in how far I want to push myself growing greater. And I don't know if that's like a good thing, because I don't feel like the quality of your art is directly related to how much time you spend on it. You know, I think a lot of brilliant artists learn how to work faster, learn how to work smarter, and therefore they take less time. But for me, I'm always aware that I'm still a student. I still have so much to learn about my craft and about art in general. And so I feel like lately I have been pushing myself to achieve a higher standard of drawings and just trying to force myself to tackle on more challenging subjects, more challenging poses. You know, a drawing that's a close-up portrait of just the face with a plain background is definitely going to take less time than a drawing that is, you know, the majority of the body with a complicated pose, with two hands, with hair, and, you know, articles of clothing, and also a complicated background. So when I sat down and actually caught myself, you know, before I went down this negative mental spiral like I usually do, where I just constantly beat myself up, when I stopped and caught myself and forced myself to analyze the situation logically, I realized, yeah, like, I'm not slowing down. I'm not sucking more and more. I am just taking longer because I have a higher standard now. I'm holding myself to a higher bar, and I'm trying to improve and trying to get better. And in the process, when you're trying to get better and trying to render more difficult pieces of artwork, there is a learning period. There's going to be a phase where you have to ramp up, where you're, you know, adjusting and adapting and learning new skills, and that's going to take more time. I think as artists, we never stop learning. Until the day we die, we'll always have a new skill that we can pick up, or a new area in which we can improve. And anytime we learn something new, it means that we are not a master at it yet, and we have to be a student. We have to fail and make mistakes and learn from our mistakes and slowly get better with practice. And that process takes more time. Whether you're trying out new strategies in launching your business, or trying out a new medium, or trying out different poses and venturing away from your comfort zone, anytime you want to learn and do better and grow, it's going to also set you back. And so I just wanted to share this recent revelation, I guess, with you guys, because I know artists, like, we're all our own worst critic. We compare ourselves to other artists, and most importantly, we also compare ourselves to our past selves. So if we ever fail, or, you know, backslide, or, you know, feel like we're not as good as we used to be, it's so easy to beat ourselves up and feel discouraged. And I'm a victim to that all the time. So I just wanted to share this with you guys and hopefully give you guys some encouragement and let you know that you're not alone, that you're not a failure, and that you're not backtracking, but maybe, just maybe, you're actually moving forward and progressing. And this is just a side effect of that. Anyways, this about wraps up my rambling for today. Thank you guys again for sticking with me and for watching this video. I also wanted to share these beautiful entries for my $1 coloring challenge these past few months. I'm so proud of these amazing artists, and it always delights me to see their interpretation of my line work. If you'd like to join this month, pledge at least $1 at patreon.com/happydartist. In addition to the coloring challenge, there are so many more amazing rewards on my Patreon page, including tutorials, exclusive videos, podcasts where I answer your art questions, a monthly live stream with me in my studio, and so much more. I'd love to have you join my Patreon family, and again, you can find me at patreon.com/happydartist. And also, if you want to follow along with my daily snapshots of my works in progress, scanned paintings, and just everyday artist life, you can check out my Instagram, and my handle is @happydartist. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!